All right, I'm excited because we have some very good friends with us. They've driven all the way down from Pittsburgh. They arrived last night, and they're going to be with us for a whole month, leading worship for the month of October. Now, some of you said, well, wait a minute, I thought we just hired a worship leader. We did, but this is how God's timing is so perfect. We had arranged for Greg and Rebecca to come months ago, and we didn't know that our new worship leader, Aaliyah, was right around the corner. So she is here. She's working behind the scenes. She's putting the band together. She's getting things arranged. She'll start officially sort of in November, but we're honored and happy to have with us Greg and Rebecca Sparks. Let's stand together and worship.
Delighted to be here. You know, Greg and I have been worship leaders, missionaries, musicianaries, as I like to say, for 43 years. And I have never experienced such a long spell of not being in the house of the Lord and worshiping with God's people in the flesh. This is the first time since February. I know, I am blown away to be able to be here with you. We asked the Lord months ago, said, Lord, wherever people are worshiping in the flesh, send us. And Phil called. So, and he said, we'll go to Florida. So that's what we're doing here. I want you to say this with me. You know, the Psalms are beautiful calls to worship. And, but there's always this great, like, call and response thing happening in the Psalms that sometimes I think we miss because we forget that they were people just like us, perhaps a little bit louder than we like to be. But I want you to learn this line. It's just one line. His loving kindness endures forever. Say that with me. His
loving kindness endures forever.
All right, so when I point to you, you go ahead and you say this, all right? Ready? All right, here we go. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
His loving kindness
endures
forever.
Oh, let Israel say.
His loving kindness endures forever.
Let the house of Aaron say.
His loving kindness endures forever.
Oh, let those who fear the Lord say.
His loving kindness endures
forever. The word of the Lord says, don't trust in noble people. Don't trust in princes. He said, this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. And all of us who rely on God, the Father Almighty, Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, the power of the Holy Spirit breathing and moving in us, we all say and declare in this place, there is no other God before our God. And we all know that his... Awesome. Sing together.
Giving out.
goodness, when I consider your mercy, when I consider your faithful way with me. I am humble, brought down low, to where I need to be, to where the heart of heaven graces be.
All right, how many have heard that song before? You know it? Raise your hands. That is only because you have been in church while I've been in church, because we wrote that song and it's nowhere else. So we're going to sing that part again, but I promise when we get to the chorus, it's super easy. It just says one word over and over, okay? All right, so we'll do this from the beginning. When I consider, all right, clap your hands.
When I consider your goodness, when I consider your mercy, when I consider your faithful way with me. Us to be people who praise him. The scripture said, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I'm going to say it, rejoice. And many of us who are churchgoers, we're very troubled by that because we feel like we're not being heard. We feel like we're not being understood because life is hard, right? Sorry, I have difficulty if I don't see your face. Life is hard, right? Right. These past months, this whole year, it's been somewhat brutal, right? A lot of loss, a lot of changes, so many things that we can't have, can't do. So many of the things that caused us to gather together, and God in the middle of it all just keeps saying, rejoice in me, always. Why?
because we were created to praise God. From the very beginning, we were created. Just like the trees and the rocks, the mountains and the waters, the birds. That is creation in perfection. So we don't praise God because we feel awesome. Good. Goodness gracious. We would never praise, right? But we praise God out of obedience because we are creatures of praise. And we find that when we settle our hearts and we start to just zoom in and say, oh, I'm setting it all down. I'm setting it all down, Lord. All of my worries, all of my sorrow, I'm going to set it down right now here in your presence. Can you do that? Can you do that? Because you know what Jesus says? Come to me. All of you who are weary, all of you who are carrying far too much, and I will bring you rest. Don't you want to rest? Don't you want to breathe deep the breath of God? Just rest in Him. I invite you to take whatever posture you love for prayer. I am a kneeler by nature. I was already born close to the ground. I didn't get much farther away in my adulthood. 5 feet isn't too far away. But what I love about getting low is it reminds me who I am in the presence of God, and that is nothing. So I invite you, we're going to pray, we're going to sing, we're going to open up our heart to the possibility that God is telling the truth when He says, humble yourself in the presence of the Lord and I will lift you up. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, what promises He has for us, not just individuals, but as communities, as nations. Will you humble yourself in the presence of the Lord? What do you have that is so great? What have you built? What have you done that could compare to the handiwork of God? Not one of us could cause the next breath to come, but God can, and God could take that away. He has that power. We know that. So rest yourself and delight yourself in His kindness and His goodness, because His loving kindness endures forever. Thank you. Tim Keller, he says, even the good things could become God things. We indulge too much, we focus too much, we pour too much of our energy, our time, our brain space, and before you know it, they shout over the voice of God. What a privilege it is to be able to settle our hearts and lay it all aside. Breathe deep the breath of God, His Holy Spirit, as always, because God never breaks His promises. His Holy Spirit is right here with us right now. Will you receive what God is saying to you? Even the hard and challenging thing, receive it. And as soon as you know what God is saying, man, run to obey. Run to obey. Sing, there is no one else for me. There is no one else for me. None but Jesus. Crucified to set me free. Now I live to bring Him praise. There is for me.
the centerpiece of all that we do. His body broken for us, his blood shed for us, so that we may not only commune with him, our Father in heaven, but with one another. The strength in the body of Christ. We'll sing this song. You don't know this one because I wrote it not long ago, but you'll learn it. And continue to just let your heart be softened. Slow down the pace of the busyness in your brain as we lift up the precious, mighty, powerful name of Jesus and all of the possibility of what God can do with a broken and willing vessel.
Mercy on me.
Sins, that we may delight in your will.